Did you guys know that cybersecurity professionals use malware sandboxing to identify potentially malicious software? I'm Paula J from CQURE, and in this episode, I'm going to show you how actually malware sandboxing works. So why this subject is important? Well, first of all, we need to know how malware works in a safe environment. And at the same time, while understanding it, we're able to design appropriate prevention technique. So let's take a chance to outsmart the hackers and let's dig in.
Okay guys, so you should see my screen right now, and today we're going to talk about Windows Sandbox. Windows Sandbox provides desktop environment to safely run applications in isolation. And software that's installed inside Windows Sandbox environment runs separately from the host machine. So Sandbox, in general, it's temporary, and when it's closed, all software files and so on, and in general all the files and the machine state are deleted. So software and applications installed on the host that aren't really directly available in the sandbox, they must be explicitly installed within the environment. So the goal for this demonstration is to show you how to properly configure and use Windows Sandbox for malware analysis. First of all, we need to install Windows Sandbox, and for me it's already installed, but you need to first make sure that you are using Windows 10 Pro or Enterprise with the version 1904 or later of Windows 10. So that's one thing. Second, you need to make sure that CPU's virtualization is enabled in the computer's BIOS. So first of all, if you would like to install the Windows Sandbox, you need to go to Windows Features, and that's over here. And then we will need to search for the Windows Sandbox. So long story short, you will be able to find it over here. Yeah, and that's the checkbox Windows Sandbox. And after the installation, that takes a moment, you will need to reboot Windows operating system. And after completing all these steps, you can start the Windows Sandbox. And basically, you just need to type in Windows Sandbox within the search bar. And then basically, it's going to come out, as you can see. Now, Windows Sandbox is configured using configuration files. And a configuration file itself provides customization parameters for Windows Sandbox. And in general, they are formatted as XML, and they are associated with Sandbox via the WSB file extension. So in order to be able to use configuration file, you need to just simply double click on it, and that's it. And that's going to open Sandbox. So with that file, we can edit the file to control features such as networking, folder sharing, startup scripting, etc. And what is also cool is that Windows Sandbox supports the ability to automatically execute a command when, of course, the sandbox is started using the directive. So over here, for example, what we can have a look at first is that if we edit Sandbox for procmon in Notepad++, so here you are able to see that we've got a folder defined, CQURE sandbox file tools, and then eventually that is also where the certain file is going to be available. Yeah, so you can edit, for example, all these files in Notepad, no problem about that. And whenever we are thinking, of course, about double clicking on this file, let's see what's going to happen. So we get a sandbox procmon, yeah. Then in the moment, we are actually over here opening Windows Sandbox. And after a moment, we will be able to see isolated process monitor running. So that is the setup. And it's going to take a moment. Over here, it also asks us about some network, so let's just say no for that moment. But eventually, we will be able to see that particular procmon running. So you can see right now that we've got the Windows Sandbox window opened, and in a second, we're going to see the procmon. And now it appeared, we can see that that's the sandbox. So this is isolated environment that we got, and over here we've got a procmon running. Yeah, so as simple as this, we are able to play with a software itself. So it's a really nice way to play with the, for example, malware isolation. Well, anyway, so let's close this one, and we can just close it, and then everything gets lost over here. And then the next stage for us, it's going to be to play with the sandbox that we would be able to use, for example, for malware isolation. So over here, we've got CQURE sandbox, and in a second, we're going to look into the configuration of the file. In the meantime, we've got a question. Are you sure you want to close Windows Sandbox? Yes, we are sure, absolutely. And after that, we are ready to dig in into the next demonstration. So over here, we've got CQURE Sandbox. Let's just edit it with Notepad++. And over here, you've got definitely more parameters that we had before. So we've got here information whether we want to have networking or not, audio input, video input, and so on. So these features are allowing us to impact how eventually we will be able, for example, to analyze malware. So long story short, let's see what we can do with this particular configuration file. And over here, we've got a CQURE folder, sandbox files, malware. That's going to be our host folder. And then we've got also this particular folder that we're going to be sharing over here. So let's give it a try, if you don't mind. So we've got a CQURE sandbox. So we are as well double clicking on it. And in the moment, we're going to have a machine with the possibility of getting into the particular folder. So right now we can see the Windows Sandbox window, and in a second as well, we're gonna see that particular, for example, folder virtualized in a sense. So this particular folder is opened automatically, and over here we are able to share particular folder and drop in here, for example, malware, and run malware in this particular folder. Just to verify that this particular folder is working, we were defining over here the path for a CQURE and then sandbox files. And over here, we've got malware or eventually tools. And this is PuTTY original or PuTTY original. And over here, we are able to see that that's basically the same file. So eventually, we are also able to share folders in between each other.
Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you're gonna download the package with the tools from this episode from our blog, secureacademy.com/blog. And in order to get more episodes, more information, definitely please visit our blog. Thanks so much for watching.